Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to improve our math skill. Today is our lesson number 171 in the series of basic math. Today we'll solve a problem on the topic of ratio and proportions. Originally, I had planned to make 20 lessons, 20 videos on the topic of ratio and proportions. I decided to add two more to it. Hence the 20A, 20B, and today is the very last one, 20C, the very last one, 20 of 20, A, B, and C, because I decided to add, as I said, two more. The problem for today is already on the blackboard. As a matter of fact, it is not a problem in itself. It's in fact a redo. It's a redo of day number 157. If you have not watched day 157, make sure you watch the video 157, otherwise none of this will make sense. What happened was that, here's what happened. What happened was that when we were solving the problem for day number 157, I did the problem in a very classical, very orthodox, very traditional, very academic way. And towards the end of it, I wanted to show you the quick and dirty way. And I forgot to do it and I closed the video. And it's been bothering me. So just to get it out of my system, we're going to do it right here. So these are the four ratios. If you watch the videos, you will see what this ratio stands for. We're not going to get into it. The point here is that the ratio of S to L is 5 to 3, F to S is 7 to 10, T to L is 5 to 6, and the question simply is, what's the ratio of F to T? If you have not watched day number 157, try it yourself first without actually watching day 157. Try it yourself right now and see what you can do. I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video and see what you can do first. If you try it yourself first, you'll be better able to appreciate the faster way. I'll give you 5 seconds, and then you'll compare your work against the work that you and I will do together. Okay, here we go. Okay, in a classical way, in a traditional way, in the academic way, if you ask your math teacher to help you with this problem, he or she will do the problem in the exact same manner that we did, which is the person will look for this exact specific ratio, F to T, and nothing else. It's counterintuitive. It's counterintuitive. If you look for this ratio by itself, F to T, just one ratio by itself, it actually takes much longer than try to find the ratio of, let's put down all of them here, F to S to T to L. These are the four variables. If you look for the ratio of these in one shot, it actually takes less time. I'm going to show you how to do it. We're going to learn now how to do it. So here we go. Are you with me? We're just going to pick our ratios and insert them right here and just watch and see, watch what happens. S to L is 5 to 3. So that's the first ratio. Let's call it number 1 so we know where it is coming from. This is number 1. Then we have F to S is 7 to 10. F to S is 7 to 1. 7 to 10. F to S. 7 to 10. There you go. 7 to 10. 7 to 10 is F to S, and this is number 2. And right there you have to pause. Right there you have to pause because the numbers cannot differ. Here we have 5 and here we have 10. That won't do. That won't fly. We have to convert this 5 into a 10. How do we convert this 5 into a 10? We'll multiply 5 by 2. Multiply it by 2 and this becomes 10. And if you multiply this by 2, we have to go back and change this thing to 6. That's it. We're done. So that 10 to 6 is still number 1. This is still number 1. Ratio number 1. Ratio of 10 to 6 is same as 5 to 3. Ratio of 10 to 6 is same as 5 to 3. And this is 7 to 10, which is right from here. Are you with me so far? Finally, we have T to L, which is 5 to 6. T to L. Where is T? Right here. T to L. 5 to 6. Oh, there you go. 5 to 6. So here we don't have to do anything at all. Here we have a 6 and here we have a 6. That 6 just comes down. We don't have to do anything at all. There we go. That's it. That was ratio number 3. And we're done. That's it. There you go. All done. The ratio of the four variable is 7 to 10 to 5 to 6. Now we can answer the question that they're looking for, which is F to T. Where is the F? Right here. This is the F. Let me put it in a different color because we do have the flair for the dramatic. F to T right here. F to T. F to T right here. And F is our 7 and T is our 5. Therefore, F to T is simply going to be 7 over 5. All done. All done in a matter of few seconds. all done in a matter of few seconds, as opposed to the way we did it before, which was the traditional way. As I said, it was the orthodox, classical, conventional way, academic way, which took us few minutes. This can be done in a matter of few seconds. What we're going to do now is, I'm going to give you another problem right now. We're going to do it together. Second problem, I'm going to set it up on the blackboard, and then you're going to do it yourself first. Okay, here's the new problem. So this is a brand new problem. Here we go. We're being told that A to B, ratio of A to B is 3 to 4. Ratio of B to D is 8 to 5. Ratio of C to D, we are told, is 3 to 2. And the question simply is, what's the ratio of A to C? A to C is how much? That's a C. There we go. One more time. A to B is 3/4, ratio of B to D is 8 to 5, ratio of C to D is 3/2. Question is, what's the ratio of A to C? Pause the video at this point. I insist that you pause the video, you do it yourself. Once you have done it, then compare your work against the work that you and I will do together in a few seconds time, as always. Okay, I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Do it yourself first. Here we go. So again, instead of looking for the ratio of A to C, we're just going to look for all the ratios together. So, A to B to C to D. And we're going to start inserting the values. Here we go. A to B is 3/4. 3/4. 3 to 4. So that one is done. That's the ratio number 1. That one is done. Of course, had it been a real exam, we wouldn't be so damned that you actually put down 1 here. I'm just doing it for your benefit. B to D is 8 to 5. B to D, where's B? Right here. 8 to 5. 8 to 5. Do you see right here? This is the 4. This is the 4. And this is the 8. That won't do. We need to convert that 4 into an 8. How do we do it? Well, simple. Multiply it by 2. Make it 8. If you're going to multiply that by 2, we need to go back and multiply this by 2. It becomes 6. This is the same ratio as... this is still ratio number 1. Ratio of A to B is 3 to 4, we are told. 3 to 4 is same as 6 to 8. 6 to 8, now we have our 8, and this is 8 to 5, which is right here. So we are done with second ratio. This is second ratio. We are almost done. We are almost done. C to D, we are told, is 3 to 2. 3 to 2. C, 3, 2, 2. Things are going to get a little prickly. Things are going to get a little prickly. Pay attention, okay? Pay very close attention. C to D. C to D. So this is C, C to D. D is right here. C to D is 3 to 2. The problem is that here we have 5, here we have 2. What do we need to multiply 2 by to make it a 5? We don't want to convert 5 into a 2, because if you converted 5 into a 2, we're going to have to go back and adjust everything else. So we build from the bottom up. So this is the last layer. This is the topmost layer. How do you convert this 2 into a 5? Well, that's very simple. 2 times 2 and a half. 2 times 2 and a half is 5. Well, if you're going to multiply this number by 2 and a half, you've got to go back and multiply this by 2 and a half. I hope you're able to see all this work. I left very little room to play around. There you go. 3 times 2 and a half to 2 times 2 and a half is same as 3 to 2. We have not changed anything. Still is 3 to 2. We just multiply this number by 2 and a half and multiply that number by 2 and a half. That's it. We are done. Now we can answer our question. The question is, what is A to C? Where is A? Let's bring it down. A to C. A, which is 6. Bring it down. A to C. Where is C? Right here. C is 3 times 2 and a half, which is... well, how much is 3 times 2 and a half? I don't want to take chances here. I don't want to take a chance. I'm going to actually do it out. 3 times 2 and a half. 3 times 2 and a half. I'm going to do it out. As I said, 3 times 2 is 6. And 3 times half is 3 halves. But 3 halves is 1 and a half. Because 2 halves is 1. If you have a half and a half, 2 halves is 1. 3 halves is 1 and a half plus 6 is 7 and a half. So the answer is, it is 6 to 7 and a half. 6 to 7 and a half. Our answer is... 6 to 7.5, let's put it here. A to C, let's do it here. A to C is 6 to 7.5. Of course, we can't leave it like that. In the exam, we can't leave it like this. We have to work on it. We have to present it in a little bit more elegant manner. Because in the exam, in the real exam, whether you're preparing for ACT, SAT, TEs, or GMAT, or GRE, the answer choice is not going to be presented like this. This is a very crude presentation. We need to get rid of this 7.5, convert it into a whole number. How do we do that? It's very simple. Multiply top and bottom by 2. Are you with me so far still? And that becomes 6 times 2, which is 12. And 7.5 times 2 is going to be 15. And we are still not done. Now we see 12 on the top, we see 15 on the bottom. 12 is a multiple of 3, 15 is a multiple of 3. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. 12 becomes 4, and 15 becomes 5. And the final answer is A to C is 4 to 5. A to C is 4 to 5. Right here, 4. 4 to 5. 4 to 5. That's all. That was it. The answer is, what was the ratio of A to C they were asking? The answer is 4 to 5. Something like this in the exam will not appear as an easy question, will not appear as a medium question. This question definitely qualifies as a hard question. Now, if you're preparing for the GRE or the GMAT, what I'm about to say would not apply to ACT or SAT or TEs, but if you're preparing for GRE or GMAT, these exams are what are known as computer adaptive, particularly the GRE. If you see something like this in your exam, that actually is a very good sign. That means you have graduated to the topmost level of the difficulty. That means you're getting mostly hard questions. You're going to get a very good score in the exam. If you keep seeing easy questions one after the other, easy one, the next one comes up is easy one, they're all easy one, that is not a good sign. Because it's not letting you graduate to the medium and the hard one. This, as I said, will not qualify as an easy or a medium one. This definitely would qualify as a hard question. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.